Simple question. Is someone getting fired for all the problems with the Obamacare rollout? Watch what happens when our own Ed Henry asked about that at today's White House briefing.
Short of somebody being fired, what kind of accountability will there be? Specifically, I haven't heard you ask about this company, two companies, I think, GCI Federal and Quality Software Services. They've got millions of dollars in federal contracts for the website, the data collection, etc. And when even Robert Gibbs is saying it's been botched, is there an investigation of this company? Is this company planning to turn over? This is millions of dollars.
Questions about contracts related to this are ones that should be addressed to HHS and CMS. I don't have that information. What I can tell you is the accountability the president seeks today is the accountability that comes from those who are working on implementation, working around the clock to ensure that the consumer experience is improved.
Joining me now, Kristen Soltis Anderson, a Republican pollster and vice president of the Winston Group, and Simon Rosenberg, a Democratic analyst and president of NDN, a progressive think tank. All right, so here's my question. The reason we say who's getting fired and not should somebody be fired is they've gotten over $93 million of the taxpayers' money just to set up the websites, which apparently stink. $93 million. So we talked about this with Pete Hegseth, accountability. Where is the accountability for that failure? Kristen?
I feel really bad for Jay Carney on days like this when he has to defend this sort of disastrous rollout. He's got a tough job trying to say that there's accountability and everything will be fine. The real accountability needs to come where key decisions were made that have led to this being such a disaster. First, there's a decision that was sort of made at the top to not roll out a lot of the parameters for what these exchanges would look like until after the 2012 election so that Republicans wouldn't have the parameters as a way to attack Democrats. So that goes all the way up to the top. That's President Obama, who they decided to sort of preserve his ability to be reelected. Hey, let's not create a political situation where we roll out these restrictions.
They're not going to fire him.
The current administration
is not going to fire him. So Simon, let me ask you. I mean, this obviously, this has been disastrous. The rollout has been disastrous. That's why you have Robert Gibbs, who's a huge advocate of the president, out there saying, someone needs to get fired. This was not well handled, and it really may have cost this law and support of this law people's perception of it. Your thoughts?
Well, I don't think anybody should be fired now, Megan. We got to try to fix the exchanges. I mean, I think the most important thing is, let these guys go to work. Let Kathleen Sebelius and the team that's there try to get these things fixed the next month, 6 weeks. If by then this hasn't been fixed and the exchanges aren't up and running, then I think that, you know, we'll be at a very different place in terms of accountability, public perception. And obviously the Republicans in the House are going to be all over this. So they'll be having to account to the House of Representatives. But give them a little bit more time.
It is working in some states, right? Some of the state exchanges
are working, right?
You guys are agreeing that needs to get fixed. I mean, obviously, if we're going to have this law, which we are, it needs to get fixed. But we're asking about accountability tonight. You know, that's sort of the theme of tonight's show. Where's the accountability for the debt? Where's the accountability for those who really gave the short end to our military? And where's the accountability for what's happened with this rollout? Because we paid for it. You guys, my viewers, I paid $100 million to make sure that the websites worked, and they didn't. And now they had, according to the Washington Post, traffic plunging 88% at healthcare.gov since its launch. Apparently, a million people or 10 million people tried to go look at it, Kristen, but only 36,000 actually registered.
Yeah, and so Simon's timeline of, you know, a month to 6 weeks or so, that's almost a generous timeline. I mean, the real big problem here is that if young people, healthy people, aren't signing up in these exchanges, if they're being deterred because they hear what a disaster it is, these exchanges can't work without young and healthy people in the system. The original estimates were that we'd need about 7 million people in these exchanges, and about 40% of them would have to be the young and healthy people. If people who are really sick and really need coverage are the ones who are hitting refresh, refresh, refresh until they can get these sites to work, but the young, healthy people are saying, you know what, I can't deal with this, just forget it, I'll pay the penalty. The exchanges don't work, and you wind up going into what they call sort of the insurance death spiral.
Death spiral.
The pool gets thicker and thicker, the premiums get higher and higher until the whole system breaks. I don't even know that 6 weeks is an effective time frame here, because time is running out. The fact that this rollout has been so disastrous at this point already has left a big impression for people who might have been considering going into the exchanges that the system is just a mess and I want no part of it.
Simon?
Well, look, I think a lot has gone right with the Obamacare rollout over the last year and a half, right? We have millions of young people who are covered today that weren't before. No one now has to worry about pre-existing conditions knocking them out of insurance. There are pieces of this that have gone well, and some of the states are actually working very well, the ones that are not part of the federal exchange. But Kirsten, I think the key thing here is if we go into December, there are two sign-up windows. There's through January 1st and then through March 31st. There has to be a couple million people signed up by the end of the year.
Yeah.
If there aren't, then we've got real problems. People don't have to write the check, pay the first premium until December. That's when crunch time comes. I mean, if there isn't a couple million people signed up, then we're going to be going to Plan B here.
Yeah, we'll have you guys back. We'll talk about, what did you call it, debt spiral? What did you call it? Insurance debt
yeah,
spiral.
Was, yeah. She was good. She All was right. good, wasn't she? Yeah.
Thank you both. Thanks for being here. Again, Dr. Craig. Well, his lawyer says he is being used as a scapegoat by the Army. A 20-